In September 2023, the US Air Force announced that the B-21 Raider had commenced engine runs as part of its ground test program at a Northrop Grumman facility. November 2023 saw the aircraft's first flight. While the B-21 is a few years from entering service, it's hailed as the world's first sixth-generation aircraft. We don't often cover military aviation, but today let's change things up a little and take a look at Northrop Grumman's B-21 Raider. When it comes to advanced military aircraft, development timelines are often longer than commercial aircraft. Indeed, the US Air Force started planning for a next-generation stealth bomber way back in 2011. The bomber was officially named as the Raider in 2016 and was then unveiled to the public at a ceremony on December 2, 2022 in Palmdale, California. While its recent first test flight is a huge milestone, the aircraft isn't expected to enter service until 2027. So what specifics do we know about this jet? Well, the B-21 makes use of the latest stealth technology, as well as advanced networking capabilities and open systems architecture. The Raider is designed to provide the Air Force with long-range, high survivability and mission payload flexibility. Its open architecture allows for rapid upgradability, from the inclusion of new weapons to software upgrades. The B-21 team is made up of over 8,000 personnel, not just from Northrop Grumman, but also industry partners and the Air Force. Indeed, the program includes some 400 suppliers across 40 states. Industry partners listed by the US Air Force include Pratt & Whitney, Janicki Industries, Collins Aerospace, GKN Aerospace, BAE Systems, and Spirit Aerosystems. Unsurprisingly, many of the aircraft's details and specifications, as well as a production schedule, remain unknown. However, an article from Aviation Week estimates that the jet's length is approximately 54 feet or 16 meters, with a wingspan of 132 feet or 40 meters. While not yet official, most sources are speculating that the jet will be powered by a pair of Pratt & Whitney PW9000 non-afterburning turbofans. These will each have a thrust of 27,000 pound force. The US Air Force plans to acquire at least 100 aircraft, although some defense analysts believe that the Air Force should plan to purchase at least 200 of the type. In 2022, the Air Force estimated the average unit procurement cost, or cost per aircraft, would be $692 million. The US Air Force has identified Ellsworth Air Force Base in South Dakota to be the first recipient of the aircraft. What do you think of this upcoming military aircraft? And would you like to see more military coverage on this channel? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment down below. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.